Interesting. Let's see if it has some true powers. Pretty good. Back to you, Ben.
Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace Aleya, and I hope you enjoyed that little intro. As you might know, if you follow me on Instagram, I made this video in collaboration with Ben from PressTube. PressTube is actually one of the biggest channels here in Belgium, and meeting Ben was really amazing, and he's a very humble guy. It was a true honor. Thank you so much, and hopefully we can do this in the future sometime too. So he does obviously some crazy stuff on his channel, otherwise he wouldn't get that audience, so definitely check him out. I'll put a link in the description below so you can go and check out his channel. So he made the hammer that you saw in the intro completely by himself from aluminium. His video on that actually went viral, so I wanted to add some effects to that hammer. It would be a shame if that hammer was never to be used in a VFX scene, right? So anyway, we had lots of fun creating this one. The hammer was actually really, really heavy. I was truly shocked, pun intended. Okay, so let's get to the point and see how it's done. And by the way, if you enjoy watching my videos, definitely hit subscribe. And don't forget the little bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. If you want the same footage as me, you can download the tutorial files in the description below. So the first thing that you want to do is change your color space in Adobe After Effects to 32 bits per channel. This will allow us to achieve better colors and better glows. Next, I will drag in my footage into a new composition so we can get started. The first thing that I want to do is duplicate my footage. On this new layer, I want to apply an effect color correction colorama. This will be used to create a luma mat so we can sky replace a shot with a stormier sky to match the lightning scene a little bit. Go to the output cycle of colorama and change it to ramp gray. Create two new points, one black and one white, and then play with the position until your sky looks white and everything else black. Just try to really pay attention to the trees and kind of make it a subtle gradient. You can still tweak these settings later on. Once you are done, import an image or video of a sky that you want to use. Unfortunately, I can't share this sky, but I'm sure you can figure out this one by yourself. Drag in the sky below the luma mat layer that we just created. Change the track mat to luma mat. If you still need to adjust the colorama effect, you can still do so. So make sure it is as perfect as possible. Then reposition the sky to your preference. Next, I'm going to apply a color correction, tint effect, and a curves effect to the sky layer. Decrease the tint to desaturate the sky a little bit and play with the curves until it matches your scene better. Also play with the opacity of the sky layer to blend it in a little bit better. That's also a great trick when you do sky replacement. Once you are done, pre-compose all these layers, and this is going to be our footage layer. Now let's take a short break for today's video sponsor. If you are a creative of some sort and you want to get your name out there, you'll need a website. A website is your digital business card to send out to new potential clients and also to be more visible on the web. A website can either make or break a deal, and I'm not kidding, I've been through this one in the past. Make sure it looks great and not outdated. Wix.com is a professional website builder and today's video sponsor, and they have super straightforward tools to make a professional looking website on your own. You don't need any knowledge of coding, and they have plenty of templates to choose from, which you can also modify to your preferences. Also, for the videographers out there, they have Wix Video, which is an amazing tool to integrate your videos in a very professional and presentable way on your website. If you want to find out more about Wix.com, definitely follow the link in the description below, and I was actually able to get a nice discount code for you guys, so you can also find that in the description below. Okay, back to the video. Let's create some awesome lightning effects. Let's add an exposure effect to the pre-composed layer that we just created, and I'm going to set the value to 0.5. I made a mistake of going for 1, but that's a little bit too high. So choose 0.5 for the exposure, and then I'm going to alt-click on the stopwatch of the exposure effect and write a simple expression to give it some flickering light. Write wheel, open parentheses, 10, 0.5, close parentheses. This is going to change 10 times a second with a value of 0.5 randomly. Next, I'm going to create a new adjustment layer. We are going to convert our footage to look a little bit more like a night scene. I'm going to apply an effect, curves and tint again. Change the tint to some kind of dark bluish color. and then lower the percentage of the effect to blend in a little bit better. And then you can play with the curves effects to add a little bit more contrast and colors. Next, I want to duplicate my footage and bring it on top originally. Here I want to use a pen tool to mask an area around my body that is kind of gonna be the most reflected lightning on my body. Then I'm also going to add an ellipse mask to reflect in the background. Adjust it a little bit to look a little bit more 3D, and then I'm going to feather these masks to my preferences. Change the blending mode of this layer to additive or screen. Next, I'm going to duplicate my footage once again and bring it above this layer. Now we're going to add a tint effect to desaturate the entire footage, and then I'm going to add a levels effect to add more contrast. What we essentially want to create is some kind of specular map so that the reflections don't look even everywhere. So everything that's white is going to be visible and everything that's black isn't going to be visible. So try to think about it as a specular map. Then use the reflection layer and change the track matte to luma matte. Now only the white parts of the layer above will be reflected, and that creates this kind of effect. Cool. You can always play with the colors a little bit more using a curves adjustment, but that's completely up to you. Okay, now for the exciting part, let's create some lightning. Add a new black solid layer to the composition and add an advanced lightning effect to that layer. The first thing that I want to do here is change the glow opacity to 0, then I'm going to set the core width to around 6 and again alt click on the stopwatch. Again, I'm going to write that same expression, wiggle open parentheses 10, comma 5 this time and close the parentheses. This is going to animate the width also randomly of the lightning. Then keyframe the lightning origin to the hammer. Of course, you could also track the hammer and then link the origin, but let's keep it simple for now as I don't move the hammer too much. Also change the lightning type to a strike and animate it to something like this. Trim the layer to where you want the lightning to start, and there we go. Next, I want to also animate the lightning animation. This we can do with the conductivity state of the lightning effect. We are also going to write a simple expression in this case, so also alt click on the stopwatch for the conductivity state. Here I'm going to write the expression time times 2. So now it's going to have a constant animation, and therefore the lightning is going to look animated. Lastly, you can play with all the other lightning settings, but I found that the basic ones actually work pretty well in this case. After you have everything set up, you can change the core color to some kind of blue, but don't saturate it too much. Next, I want to apply our perfect glow preset, which gives you great glow results. You can download that for free on our website. I will put a link in the description below. Once you apply that, you will see that the glow looks off. That's because you should check on composite on original in the lightning effect. Then change the blending mode of this layer to screen, and now play with the glow threshold, radius and intensity to get satisfying results. After that, you can also move the lightning direction if you want to give it a little bit more life, and then I will import my flare footage, which is going to be included in the tutorial files in the link in the description below. Also set this layer to a screen and scale it, and maybe apply a simple curves effect to darken the darks a little bit more so you don't see any edges on that flare. Then I'm going to press P on the keyboard for the position of that layer, and then alt click on the stopwatch for the position. I'm going to link this to the original value of the lightning effect. Also trim this layer where the lightning starts. Next, let's take a look on how to create the lightning in the sky. I'm going to duplicate my lightning effect so we don't have to start over from scratch and put it on the top. Solo it for now so we can concentrate on that layer and disable all the glow effects and change the lightning type to breaking. Play with the forking and decay to get your desired results and animate the origin and direction to get some variation in it. I'm again going to use the wiggle expression to both the origin and direction because I'm just too lazy to animate them. Then I'm going into the core settings and also add a wiggle expression to the opacity so that the lightning flickers on and off and isn't constant. Now let's enable the glow effects again and adjust the settings. As there is way more lightning than before, the glow is going to be way too intense, so lower it a bit until you're satisfied. You can still dive in the core thickness and the color to get different kind of results, so really play around with that, and then you can unsolo that layer, pre-compose it so we have that separate. Then I'm going to jump into the composition of my footage where we keyed out the sky. I'm going to copy the luma mat that we created and paste it back in our main composition. Put that above the latest lightning composition that we just created and change the lightning layer to again luma mat so that the lightning only appears in the sky. Adjust the timing of the lightning layer to your preferences and again trim it to where the lightning begins, and voila! Next, let's finalize our clip with some minor details that will enhance our look a lot. add an adjustment layer on the top and create an ellipse mask tool by just double clicking on that. Then subtract that mask and feather it a bit. Here we are going to apply a curves adjustment and bring down the intensity. This will create some kind of vignette on the edges and make the edges darker. Once you've done that, we really want to emphasize the power of the lightning when I put the hammer in the air and get the first lightning strike going. To do that, we want to add a subtle camera shake effect, and I'm going to be using TC Shake, which is a preset from our Epic Transitions pack. If you don't have that, you will find a ton of tutorials on how to add shake to your footage online. Again, this you do on a new adjustment layer. For the TC Shake, bring the first keyframe right before the effect happens and then bring the center keyframe to the position where the effect starts. Then the last keyframe just makes it fade out. Change the settings to your preferences and boom, we have the shake to really show how much power is in this shot. And okay, we're done, but for the serious people here, we can now export this clip to Premiere Pro and import it in a timeline. Here I want to add our camera shake preset, which is recorded from real organic camera movement, to give this shot a little bit more detail and depth. This will make it look so much more advanced, and voila, we're done. If you want to add sound effects, all I did was I used the trailer track from Epidemic Sound and sound effects from their website as well, so everything that I got from sound is all from Epidemic Sound. And if you click on the link in the description below, you can actually use Epidemic Sound 30 days for free. So if that's not a great deal, I just don't know it anymore. So now you will be able to finish this project entirely with some awesome sound, and that's basically it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to this channel for more, and definitely hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload a new video. And also check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for any kind of digital creative. And if you buy something from our website, it really helps to support this channel and create more awesome content. And apart from that, I hope to see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.